Kaserne vor dem großen Tor stand eine Laterne und steht sie noch davor. So wollen wir uns da wiedersehen, bei der Laterne wollen wir stehen, wie einst Lili Marleen, wie einst Lili Marleen. Unsere beiden Schatten sahen wie einer aus, dass wir so lieb uns hatten, das sah man gleich daraus. Und alle Leute sollen es sehen, wenn wir bei der Laterne stehen, wie einst Lili Marleen, wie einst Lili Marleen. Schon rief der Posten, sie bliesen Zapfenstreich. Es kann 3 Tage kosten, Kamerad, ich komm ja gleich. Da sagten wir auf Wiedersehen, wie gerne würde ich mit dir gehen, mit dir, Lili Marleen.
A bittersweet victory. The Allied forces won the Battle of El Alamein in 1942, paving the way for their victory of World War II. But still, hundreds of thousands lost their lives. From South Africa, 400 known and more than 1,000 missing in action.
My name is Colonel Santry. I'm the Defence Attaché for the British Embassy.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is an international ceremony. So I ask the Defence Attachés of Germany, Italy and Greece to join me.
This commemoration is led by the Commonwealth, South Africa, Kenya and Tanzania are among world giants whose representatives laid wreaths to mark the 75th anniversary of the Battle of El Alamein.
We prepare for all kinds of warfare, of which always one, the first one will be conventional warfare, because then everything else can gel in there.
Itakwana Ngatane, SABC News, El Alamein, Egypt.
So Judy, I'm going to leave this here and a bit of Venice Farm. Rest in peace, Father. With your comrade.
Recording.
Okay, point up slightly maybe.
Pardon?
Some marks on the front.
Are you going to let me do this, or are you going to faff around?
There's some marks on the front, some lenses fucked. Fuck it, okay. Right, I want gun, yeah. This is a 94mm British gun, anti-tank gun, that was in Syria and the Palestine and the Middle East. It was not deployed in the Western Desert. For some stupid reason, this was the best gun ever. Better than the 88. 94mm, denied use where it was needed in the Western Desert. What were the generals thinking? M3, Lee Grant. Side-mounted 75mm sponsoring gun. This looks so ugly. Keith Douglas's tank. Very odd. They've put a Stuart turret on top of a Bren gun. Not sure how that works.
Handbrake. Right. You click that and drop. That block then drops down and it exposes the chamber where the is the barrel.
Yeah.
You put the round in there, you ram it with a rammer, and you lift that back up again, and the thing is then cocked and ready to go.
Okay.
And then you get your orders as to traverse left, traverse right, whatever it might be, and you fire one round, fire for effect, bang, off it goes. Then the foo forward reports back and says, add 100, add 200, add, go left 500, left, whatever. Then when they're on target, fire mission battery, and the whole battery fires on that train. The whole thing goes back.
And a battery is six guns?
Can be four, can be six, usually six. The other thing I got to do was I got to sit forward of the gun doing the target indication.
Yeah.
So the guns are behind you, and they're firing over you, and you're in the middle of it all. And that's why I say I know what it's like when a shell comes down, because the whole landscape goes. And that's with it only being, say, 500 metres away.
Is that an observer then, that, John?
Foo, forward observation.
£25. Much loved gun.
Oh, that's different again. They're observers in aircraft, which is not the same thing.
Oh.
It's very confusing. It's a lovely gun though. We used to have to, we would time the shot, and then 7 seconds before it was due to hit, someone would say splash, and we'd all look up with our binoculars. And down it would come, and you had to get the bearing exactly right.
7 seconds?
7 seconds.
Yeah. Wow.
It took longer than that to fly, but we would say, we'd work out, say it was 13 seconds, 7 seconds from that, someone would say splash. We'd all, oh, well, you'll be there with binoculars the whole time.
Yes.
So you say splash, and everyone goes, what?
Ready for.
Ready, yeah, and down it comes. Very fun.
That's good to know.
That's good fun. I used to love doing fire mission battery, you know?
Is that how long it took? 7 seconds?
No, it took 13 seconds, but 7 seconds.
13 seconds?
They start to look for the
comes impact. Down.
That is a long time.
Well, 1.2 kilometres is quite a long way. Think of the power of that gun. 1.2 kilometres.
Well, that one does, which one was it? Does 12 kilometres.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah. The 17 kilometres, actually.
Is that 105?
The 105 over there, that's the first German gun. Chucks it a hell of a way.
Yeah.
17k.
We had 105s based in Syria, I believe, in North Africa, and they would not be released. They were always kept there for defence, whereas the North Africa and the Western Desert would have loved to have had some bigger guns.
That was come to rain us in.
Yours?
Are we lying behind?
The boss wanted.
Have you been sent to G us up a bit?
Okay, you wanna have a look inside?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
So you come now. Oh, you don't want to come. You come back and look at it later.
I do want to look at the 88.
Yes. Is that the 88 there?
Yes. Yeah. Second one? No. Not second down. Third down.
Kamerad, ich komm ja gleich. Da sagten wir auf Wiedersehen. Wie gerne würde ich mit dir gehen. Mit dir, Lili Marleen. Mit dir, Lili Marleen. Deine Schritte kennt sie, deinen schönen Gang. Alle Abend brennt sie, doch nicht vergaß sie lang. Und sollte mir ein Leid geschehen, wer wird bei der Laterne stehen? Mit dir, Lili Marleen, mit dir, Lili Marleen. Aus dem stillen Raume, aus der Erde Grund, liebt mich wie im Traume dein verliebter Mund. Wenn sich die späten Nebel drehen, werd ich bei der Laterne stehen, wie einst Lili Marleen, wie einst Lili Marleen. Wenn sich die späten Nebel drehen,
Thank you.